असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मामृतं गमय असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय
When we think of listening to spoken English, we have to remember that if the individual sound of a word is mispronounced, even the meaning can be misunderstood. For instance, the sound "tha" in English is usually pronounced "tha" in Malayalam, and therefore instead of saying "think," people say "think." But there is no breakdown in communication. One of the things that a person who speaks English has to take care of is the word stress. A word in English is composed of what is called syllable or syllables. There is a one-syllabled word like on or in or at, or his. A syllable always contains a vowel, and there are words, long words like examination, in which we have more than two or three syllables. And when in a word more than one syllable comes, the question of giving additional breath force to a particular syllable comes in. And this practice in English, in which we give additional breath force for a particular syllable, is called word stress. Word stress is very important in English, because in certain cases even the meaning can change. For instance, let's take the word represented by the spelling REBEL. If it is used as a noun, we place the stress on the first syllable and we pronounce the word rebel. Veluthambi was a rebel. And if we place the stress on the second syllable, that is bell, then it becomes a verb. Veluthambi rebelled against the king. So the word rebel represents the noun form, and rebel represents the verb form. So word stress, or what we call accent, is a very important aspect of English, which a learner of English has to reckon with. There is a story also for the children, for the learners to listen to. The story is regarding a quack doctor. A cobbler changed into a doctor owing to certain special circumstances.
Once upon a time, there lived a cobbler. The sad part of his work was that he did not really know his job. When he was handed a pair of chappals for a new set of soles, he put in soles of varying thickness so that the fellow who wore it appeared lame. Another accident occurred when he failed to properly stitch a shoe. His customer was in a hurry to get to a meeting. Consequently, he arrived at the meeting with his foot protruding out of a large gap in front. The cobbler earned more notoriety than fame and more brickbats than money. In the end, he had no option but to leave the place for good. One day, he packed all his belongings and set off. Very soon, he reached a city. Confident that he was not known in that part of the world and not so willing to continue his earlier profession, he set himself up as a doctor. Part of the house next to the post office was rented and the clinic was given a name, Healing Touch. Slowly, patients began to arrive. They were mostly cases of fever, cold and cough, which he treated with herbs from the backyard. Naturally, these diseases wore off in a week and the people were satisfied. Gradually, he began to sell bottled medicines bought from traveling quack physicians and announced that they were special life-saving medicines. He was not suspected in any way. One day, he got a house call. A wealthy landlord who owned half the city was in danger of imminent death from snake bite. The cobbler was terribly scared. He summoned all his courage, picked up his bag, and got into the vehicle that was waiting for him. The landlord's secretary was instantly suspicious of his terrified looks and cunning demeanor. He thought of a way to test the new physician before endangering his master's life further. The cobbler, meanwhile, had attempted a hasty examination of his patient. He took out his now famous antidote for snake bite and poured it into a cup of water. Just as he was about to give it to the landlord, the secretary intervened. The cup was taken from the cobbler. A liquid, supposedly poison, was added to it and the cobbler was asked to drink it. The fear of death made the cobbler confess his ignorance. He cried out that he knew nothing of medicine and that his fame was primarily due to the vulnerability of the mob he treated. "Do you think madness can go to such lengths?" thundered the secretary. These men did not hesitate to entrust their lives to a fool nobody trusted to make shoes for their feet.
Narrate the cobbler's major blunders.
When someone handed him a pair of chappals for a new set of soles, he put in soles of various thickness so that the fellow who wore it appeared lame. Another accident occurred when he failed to properly stitch a shoe. His customer was in a hurry to get to a meeting. Consequently, he arrived at the meeting with his foot protruding out of a large gap in front.
What was his new profession?
His new profession was that of a doctor.
What did he do in the second stage of his career as a doctor?
Began to sell bottled medicines bought from traveling quack physicians and announced that they were special life-saving medicines. No one suspected that he was a quack himself.
How did the landlord secretary find out the truth?
The landlord secretary was suspicious of the cobbler's terrified look and cunning manner. He thought of a way to test the new physician before endangering his master's life further. The cobbler took out his now famous antidote for snake bite and poured it into a cup of water. Just as he was about to give it to the landlord, the secretary intervened. He took the cup from the cobbler, pretended to add poison to it, and asked the cobbler to bring it. The fear of death made the cobbler confess his ignorance. He cried out that he knew nothing of medicine and that his fame was primarily due to the vulnerability of the mob he treated.
The second part of this episode relates to a person who goes into a bank in order to cash a check. This exchange between a cashier and a customer is the dialogue that is presented for you to understand the way in which this kind of an activity has to be done in real life.
Good evening.
Good evening.
The cashless traveler's check here, please.
Let me see. This is less than rupees 2000. This can be encashed at the next counter.
Thank you. Please cash this check.
Just a moment. Please take a seat. The date has been overwritten in darker ink. Could you please sign near the date?
Here it is. Will I have to wait long?
No, an entry has to be made, that's all. Here is the cash.
I would also like to send a DD to a school in Kottayam.
The DD forms are kept in that box over there. You can pay the required amount of money and do that.
Okay, also my ATM card isn't working. Can I speak to the manager about it? I come from Kottayam and some money has to be withdrawn right now. This card is valid all over Kerala, isn't it?
Of course it is. Please wait here. I'll inform the manager. He will see to it.
Thank you.
Sir, is there any problem with our ATM? Okay. The ATM unit has been down for the maintenance purposes since last night. There is another center down the road and you could try that.
Oh dear, may I make a call to my father's ING office? He works there.
Sure. What is your father's name?
P.K. Abbas. Do you know him?
Of course. So you are Abbas, son? We were together at Calicut branch for 5 years. How are your parents?
Fine, thank you. How are you, uncle?
I'm fine. I will get in touch with your father immediately. We will sort it out soon, okay? Don't worry. What brings you to Thiruvananthapuram?
I'm on a tour of the city with a small group of children. We stay at the hotel nearby.
Oh, will you come over for dinner one evening before you leave Thiruvananthapuram? I will come and pick you up at the hotel. I have 2 children, a boy and a girl. My son is about your age.
Sure, uncle. I'll do that. My father can be contacted from here, can't he? And thanks for helping me out.
It's my pleasure.
Most of us do not find banking procedures very easy to handle. This conversation at the bank has been introduced to familiarize you with easy and simple bank transactions such as cashing a check and handling an ATM unit. The following are a few sample sentences used in such a situation.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Can I cash this traveler's check here, please?
Can I cash this traveler's check here, please?
Just a moment. Could you please sign near the date?
Just a moment. Could you please sign near the date?
Will I have to wait long?
Will I have to wait long?
I would also like to send a DD to a school in Kottayam.
I'd also like to send a DD to a school in Kottayam.
Okay, also my ATM card isn't working. Can I speak to the manager about it?
Also, my ATM card isn't working. Can I speak to the manager about it? The next sentence shows you how you can politely invite a person to dinner. Will you come over for dinner one evening before you leave Thiruvananthapuram?
And thanks for helping me out.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. Let's go through this bank transaction once again.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Can I cash this traveler's check here, please?
Let me see. This is less than rupees 2000. This can be encashed at the next counter.
Thank you. Please cash this check.
Just a moment. Please take a seat. The date has been overwritten in darker ink. Could you please sign near the date?
Here it is. Will I have to wait long?
No, an entry has to be made, that's all. Here is the cash.
I would also like to send a DD to a school in Kottayam.
The DD forms are kept in that box over there. You can pay the required amount of money and do that.
Okay, also my ATM card isn't working. Can I speak to the manager about it? I come from Kottayam and some money has to be withdrawn right now. My this card is valid all over Kerala, isn't it?
Of course it is. Please wait here. I'll inform the manager. He will see to it.
Thank you.
Sir, is there any problem with our ATM?
Okay. The ATM unit has been down for the maintenance purposes since last night. There is another center down the road. You could try that.
Oh dear. May I make a call to my father's ING office? He works there.
Sure. What is your father's name?
P.K. Abbas. Do you know him?
Of course. So you are Abbas, sir? We were together at Calicut for 5 years. How are your parents?
Fine, thank you. How are you, uncle?
I'm fine. I will get in touch with your father immediately. We will sort it out soon, okay? Don't worry. What brings you to Thiruvananthapuram?
I'm on a tour of the city with a small group of children. We stay at the hotel nearby.
Oh, will you come over for dinner one evening before you leave Thiruvananthapuram? I will come and pick you up at the hotel. I have 2 children, a boy and a girl. My son is about your age.
Sure, uncle. I'll do that. My father can be contacted from here, can't he? And thanks for helping me out.
It's my pleasure.
The third part of this episode relates to teaching a little bit of functional grammar. And here, the usage that is taught is the passive form. The passive form of the verb is not natural in Malayalam. In English, the passive form helps on several occasions. There are certain linguistic occasions. For instance, you are traveling in a bus and you find that your purse is lost. And you immediately say, my pocket has been picked. Why do we use this passive form? Because we do not know who actually the agent or the person who did it is. And therefore, it's a natural language form which has to be used when the agent is unknown or the agent is unimportant. And another occasion when the passive form becomes extremely useful to us is if you are describing a process. Actually, in all chemical experiments, it is always better to use the passive form in order to describe them.
When we think of a verb, we also think in terms of action. That is, the subject, that is somebody or something doing something or being active. This is illustrated in these sentences. The lion chased the deer. Mary baked a cake. There is also the passive form, which is obtained by putting the verb in the passive voice. When we change from active to passive, there are three stages involved. One is the words, often the nouns, in the subject and object positions are interchanged. Second, the verb takes the form to be plus past participle of the verb. Naturally, to be will be in the appropriate tense form. Three, the by agent is used when the subject and object positions are interchanged. This is given in the following sentence. The man fed the beggar. Active voice. The passive of this would be, the beggar was fed by the man. The active voice is used when the doer of the action is important, as in, all of us agreed with his idea. In contrast, the passive voice has the receiver of the action as its focus. The police arrested the driver. Active. The driver was arrested by the police. Passive. In this and in similar sentences, the by agent can be dropped because it is understood. The driver was arrested is enough because we know that in procedures like an arrest, only those with the authority to do so can be involved. The passive voice is used in newspaper reports, scientific articles, and announcements. If the sentence has two objects, then two types of passive voices may be formed. As in this example, they offered James the captaincy. The captaincy was offered to James, or James was offered the captaincy. Both are possible. The passive voice has one very important use. This is shown in the following situation. Imagine that you work in an office. You have to leave in the morning. On one particular busy day, the work wasn't over by the time you left home. The dishes were in the sink. The children's toys lay all over the floor. The cat had brought in the fish bones. And you returned from the office, dreading all the work that you need to do. But a surprise awaits you when you get home. I was really surprised when I entered the flat. It was sparkling clean. The toys had been removed from the floor. The table had been cleared. The utensils had been washed. The fish bones had been thrown out. The floor had been mopped. The washed clothes had been neatly folded. I couldn't believe my eyes. Count the number of times we have used the passive voice in this passage. If you try to put the same in the active voice, we find that there is too much use of the word somebody. We will have to say, somebody cleared the table, somebody washed the dishes in the sink, somebody mopped the floor, somebody threw out the fish bones, and so on. Naturally, we agree that the passage is better put in the passive voice. As in all sentences, the subject-verb agreement is important in the active-passive voices also. In the active voice, the subject agrees with the verb. Similarly, the verb to be in the passive voice whatever be the tense form, agrees with its subject. Note the transformation from active to passive and vice versa in these sentences.
He haven't posted the letters.
The letters have not been posted.
A Japanese firm makes these TV sets.
These TV sets are made by a Japanese firm.
The daycare didn't look after the children properly.
The children weren't looked after properly at the daycare.
A lorry knocked him down.
He was knocked down by a lorry.
We cannot repair your clock.
Your clock cannot be repaired.
The milk is brought by the milkman to my door.
The milkman brings the milk to my door. This office is cleaned by three women after the staff has left.
Three women clean this office after the staff leaves.
The sick man was taken to the hospital by an ambulance.
An ambulance took the sick man to hospital.
This dress cannot be washed. It must be dry cleaned.
You can't wash this dress.
This house was searched and the stolen articles were found.
They searched his house and found the stolen articles.
He haven't posted the letters.
The letters have not been posted.
A Japanese firm makes these TV sets.
These TV sets are made by a Japanese firm.
The daycare didn't look after the children properly.
The children weren't looked after properly at the daycare.
A lorry knocked him down.
He was knocked down by a lorry.
We cannot repair your clock.
Your clock cannot be repaired.
The milk is brought by the milkman to my door.
The milkman brings the milk to my door. This office is cleaned by three women after the staff has left.
Three women clean this office after the staff leaves.
The sick man was taken to the hospital by an ambulance.
An ambulance took the sick man to hospital.
This dress cannot be washed. It must be dry cleaned.
You can't wash this dress.
This house was searched and the stolen articles were found.
They searched his house and found the stolen articles.
In all the episodes, you will find that things which are very, very important from the student's point of view. So in a correlated manner, along with language, children learn a lot of general knowledge about the Thiruvananthapuram and also Kerala in general. Secondly, the episode relates to a dialogue between a customer and a bank clerk. And the third aspect which we have discussed is the use of passives in English. And finally, there are some practice material through which the learners can practice the passive forms and make them automatic as far as communication is concerned.
Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amrtamgamaya.